Want to chime in on what's happening with your favorite KFM program? Make your voice heard on the Bradshaw and Brian text line. Let us know what you have to say by texting your message to 64686. That's 64686. Standard message and data rates apply.
I'm telling you, I want more than just romance. You are my destiny. I can't let go, baby, can't you see? Cupid, please take your aim at me.
Is Madonna in the room?
You sound like you got a nice singing voice.
You really do.
Just ask her.
Well, you never know, you know.
If I turn my head away from the microphone, you're correct.
No, that wasn't bad, though. I mean,
this is my favorite Madonna song.
Is it
so
really?
This is by request. Thank you, Tenna.
You're welcome.
I mean, some people, their voices sound like a cat getting its tail caught in a screen door, but yours doesn't.
Why are you looking at me?
No, well, it's me. You have a very nice
This
voice.
Song is better than that last one you played.
What was the last
Papa one? Don't
Papa
Preach? This
yeah.
is way, that one's way better. This
Papa
is better
Preach
than
is
that.
Very controversial, and I really am a big fan of Borderline. That's probably
That's what I was
oh,
going to
like
play.
That, but then I like
Marnie
that song.
Requested this one, yeah.
Yeah, Borderline, 80s, a late 80s, early 90s Madonna, or even the mid-90s Madonna.
Here's what I'll tell you.
Peak Madonna.
Madonna is light years above 311. Right, Cory Cove? No. You're a 311. You think they're light years ahead of Madonna.
Cherish the Look, can we hurry up? I know this is going to be super annoying, but Mike Max and LaTroy Hawkins wrote a romance novel, and I booked them for $145. So we got to hustle. Let's go.
That is true. That is true. We do have Joe Maurer coming in with Joe Schmidt and Mark Rosen. Think about the legendary people that will be in here.
So if Joe Schmidt and Joe Maurer wrote a book, why is Rosie here?
Because Rosie loves Joe so much, he wanted to be a part of it.
He facilitates.
Oh. He's, you know, yeah. Well, matter of fact, he was the one that Joe Schmidt, I think, reached out to Rosen to see if we could come on the show. Joe didn't. It's kind of my show, but I don't care.
And when you book guests without talking to the producer about it first, you should probably be here then.
Yeah, that's what I would say.
But we're Sorry, all,
well, is Rosie that. Gonna like? Ask all the questions and take over this interview?
No. He's going to give everybody a fair chance.
He's done it before, like when we're out at training camp.
Yeah.
He likes to jump in right away to show he's knowledgeable and talk to him. He'll do the old, he'll, you know, Joe, you know, did you ever, this will be one of his questions.
Okay.
Joe, did you ever think this would, when you were just a kid playing in St. Paul, did you ever really think you'd be in the Hall of Fame? Of course he didn't. Well, he would never. Joe Maurer at 8 years old ain't think I'm going to be in the Baseball Hall of Fame someday. Kids just don't think that way. I don't think, do they? But that's the kind of questions we'll get.
Just a humble, hardworking kid from St. Paul.
Do you get annoyed if he takes over? You don't care?
No, I don't.
If he cuts you off?
No.
He's listening.
Or used to it.
Yeah, it fine. Doesn't matter to me at
doesn't
all.
Doesn't matter.
I don't have a lot
Love
to
you,
ask
Rosie.
Him, to be honest. I don't have a lot to ask anybody. So I don't generally have any guests because I love the sound of my own voice.
But if you did have guests and we could actually make like a segment out of it or a podcast, what would you call it?
Dan's Discussions.
Okay.
What do you think?
It's not great.
That's for like five of us.
Discussions with Dan.
Conversations with Common.
Oh, conversations with Common.
Common conversations.
That's not bad.
The five C's, three C's.
Yeah.
We can figure something out.
We'll figure it out one way or the other.
Does this include more work for Common, though?
No, more work for Tenneby.
More work for Tenneby. Tenneby's a
not
going to
work.
Not going to work. Hey, let's play Progrum Password.
The game.
Why not?
Password. Come on, give the password. Give the password.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to play Progrum Password. Here's your host, the very average and plain-looking Tenna B.
A very special edition of Progrum Password today. This is Progrum Password Game 145.
Monumental.
It's a milestone game.
What a milestone game.
Milestone game 145.
We should be in the performance for the live audience.
And you can watch Progrum Password. You can watch Marty Gellner sing. You can watch Cory Cove wearing all black right now at KFAN.com/watch. And that stream will continue into the Joe Maurer interview today. So you can watch it all at KFAN.com/watch. Here's your Progrum Password preview. This is a pretty epic game today. Mm-hmm. Some big-time Progrum Password players of all time are in the studio right now. It's Common and Cory Cove. versus Lil B and Marney Gellner. Yeah. Common, you are 61-59
wow,
all time.
Hey. 2 over .500.
Got off the schneid last week. Your teammate, Cory Cove. 15-4 all time.
That's pretty good.
He's a Progrum Password Invitational champion. Sorry, Marnie and Libby. Also, Cory right now has an 8-game winning streak.
Whoa!
The record is 9 held by Lil B. So Cory Cove can tie the all-time record today with a winning streak.
And let it get to you.
Common and Cory, you two together as a team? Undefeated. You two are 4-0 together all time.
4-0. I thought it was 2 or 3.
Yeah,
is it only 4 times?
I didn't realize that.
Ooh.
On the other side, Lil B and Marnie Gellner. Lil B, you are 68-47. You enter with a 4-game winning streak, and you're also the all-time wins leader.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Marnie Gellner.
True.
You have the exact same record as Cory Cove all time, 15-4.
Wow.
So whoever
that
wins.
Well, hang on. How many of those 4 losses were with meat sauce?
I've never played with sauce.
I've never played with
that. Well, then
him.
Advantage me. Then my record
technically,
is better.
The analytics say you're better, Cory. Whoever wins this game today, you will be the all-time leader in terms of winning percentage in Progrum Password history. So a lot on the line. Marnie and Lil B together as a team, you guys are 13-3. There
That's
has been
pretty good.
No better team other than you guys haven't won a championship yet. But
you know, some people would say there's a lot of pressure on me for that, but I really don't care. I mean, I'm going to try, but it's,
we're going to play
if he
loose.
He doesn't get the record. He doesn't get the record.
Yeah. I mean, this isn't like it's game 149
right.
or something.
This
yes.
is
exactly.
some game 135.
Exactly.
We are doing 150 in the KFM press box, right, Lil B? It's a milestone game.
Yeah, I'm working on a sponsor right now
all right,
as we speak.
Game.
Yep.
All right, we ready to play?
Let's play.
Common and Cory versus Lil B and Marnie. Let's go Lil B and Cory. You two turn down your headsets, please.
The password is tag.
Marnie will never not make me laugh at that part. Marnie.
I've got to see it to be it.
Sorry, I should put on their microphones. Marnie, we always let ladies go first. You have the option. What do you want to do here? You want to go first or second?
Let's just go first and let's test the waters.
All right.
All right.
Let's see where we are.
Marnie and Lil B for 10.
Price.
Tag.
Wow. Esther geniuses. Wow. That was impressive.
Inflection.
I wasn't sure what it is.
Correct.
If I would have said Hoyer, would you have known what that was?
No.
Isn't that the name of a watch? Isn't it a tag? Hoyer?
Oh. Yeah, I wouldn't have got that, though.
Former NFL quarterback Brian Hoyer.
Oh, yeah.
Or he might
I don't know if that's the way it's pronounced, though, so I would have blown it anyway.
Lil B and Marnie.
It's a watch that I can't afford, but it's cool.
Oh, okay.
Lead. H-E-U-E-R.
10-0. Lil B and Marnie have the lead. Common and Marnie, headsets down, please.
The password is wall.
All right, Cory, down 10-0 early. You have the option here. You want to go first or second?
First.
Oh, sounds pretty confident. Cory and Common for 10.
Berlin
wall.
Okay.
Inflection.
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 Layup. I should have just said John.
That's what I was going to say. You wouldn't have gotten.
No, of course not. Nobody says wall after John.
I was about to say take my breath away, but then.
Fantastic
great song.
That was a bit too
Berlin.
Mm-hmm. All right, 10-10 early here. Lil B and Cory, put your headsets down, please.
The password is major.
The option, we're going to. Possession arrow says it's on Common and Cory here since the ladies started the game. So, Common, you've got the option here. Would you like to go first or second?
I'll go first.
All right. Common and Cory for 10.
Ursa.
Major. It was one of the two.
I don't know what
that's
that is.
Ursa Major and Ursa Minor are consolations.
Is it the
Dipper?
The bad girl in
it was a 50-50 shot
Little
on
Mermaid?
Lucky.
50.
Yeah, 50-50.
I was
good clue.
Taking a chance. Thank you.
In The Little Mermaid with all the tentacles?
That's Ursula.
I don't know what they're saying.
Ursa Major and Ursa Minor. We're on the same page.
Mm. Inflection. Our heads are always in the clouds. See, that's their thing.
I started dumbing down some of these words because we're going, you know, we're having like fallness and muss and murder. And now it's like, this game's too easy for you guys.
Listen.
dummy to die. That might be the best, funniest thing I've heard.
Common and Cory, you lead 20 to 10. Common and Marnie, headsets down, please.
The password is gadget.
Well, B, it's just a tennis match of tens back and forth. You've got the option here. What do you want to do?
I will go first.
All right, for another 10-pointer, Lil B and Marnie.
Inspector Gadget. Ugh.
Even Fallness and Musk would get these.
Jeez. I would have said too so, but that wouldn't have been right. Who's Inspector Gadget?
You don't know who Inspector Gadget is?
That was like a cartoon from like our era.
Inspector Gadget.
I guess I don't know.
Great show.
Well, I'm glad they went first because that would have been my exact clue, so we would have missed it.
Give it a Flintstones or Jetsons clue next time. That's more my...
Inspector Gadget.
Those cartoons are more my wheelhouse. I'm old, remember?
Yeah, I watch those cartoons.
Yeah, but I never heard of Inspector Gadget.
Well, okay.
That's okay. You guys got the points.
Thank you.
It's better that you got him right away, because if he would have said that to me, I wouldn't have known that. I would have gotten mocked and ridiculed for not knowing Inspector Gadget. So it worked out.
Barbara Walters scores 20-20 right now. Common and Cory versus Lil B and Marnie. Lil B and Cove, headsets down, please.
The password is clue.
It's tied once again, so now the possession arrow goes back to Marnie and Lil B. So Marnie, you have the option here. You want to go first or second?
We'll try first.
All right, Marnie and Lil B for 10.
Hint. Clue.
Whoa! I don't even know
who's locked in.
Why were you even debating? It's
no brainers.
Because I don't know if I said hint, like a hint of lavender, like a speck, a little.
I couldn't. I was waiting
tequila.
For you to pass.
Was that going to be your word?
The only one I had for it.
Well, good thing we got the word then. Good thing we got the choice.
It kind of reminds me of a Lions game. Everyone's just going to score touchdowns back and forth and go down to the last possession.
You've dumbed it down.
I have to.
it definitely feels easier.
I'll have to make it harder. 30-20, Lil B and Marnie have the lead now. Common and Marnie, your headsets down, please.
The password is PIN.
Cory, options back on you. You're down 10. Would you like to go first or second?
First.
Oof. You sound excited. No. Cory and Common for 10.
Needle.
Thread.
Lil B and Marnie for 9.
Safety. Pin.
I was going to say pin too. I don't know why I didn't.
I almost did safety on the first clue, but I just didn't know if that was going to be enough.
Yeah, that's too hard.
And I was going to say pin, but I decided, this is going to be more comp. I overcomplicated.
No, he dumped it down.
I dumped it down,
but
remember?
This is the fullness list.
If you start with safety, it's probably safety dance.
That's why I avoided
safety
it.
Safety squeeze.
I gambled.
Or the position safety and foot, you know. Harry the
Hitman. That's just my fault, though. That's just a terrible response.
Okay, don't be that hard on yourself.
How am I 2 games over 500?
All right, our first non-10 of the game, 39-20. Lil B and Marnie have the lead. Lil B and Cory, headsets down, please.
The password is shuttle.
A common down 19. You've got the option here. Would you like to go first or would you like to go second?
I'm going to go second.
All right. Marnie and Lil B for 10.
Challenger. Spaceship.
Cove and Common for 9.
Space.
Shuttle.
Yep.
I knew it as soon as I said it. Sorry, Marn. Well, spaceship was...
I knew I was having a chance passing on that. I didn't know if I said space if you would have said shuttle. I just didn't know.
I don't think I would have.
So that's why I decided to pass.
All right, 10-point game. Lil B and Marnie lead 39-29. Common and Marnie, headsets down, please.
The password is dude.
All right, Cory, options on you. You get a 10-pointer here. You tie the game at 39. What do you want to do, first or second?
Oh, man.
5 seconds.
Let's gamble. Let's go first.
All right. Cory and Common for 10.
Bro.
Dude.
Yeah. Yes.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Bro, dude. And it's only because I have a 21 and 18-year-old kid that I've known that. Very good. Bro, because when they're playing video games, this is all I hear. Bro, dude, yeah, they're on the headset.
Nonstop.
Bro,
non-stop.
Dude, bro, dude, bro, dude,
and you're
dude,
sus.
Bro. Over, over. Oh, what a game. What's the score?
It's 39-39 at half.
Wow. We'll break. Whoa. We'll come back with more Progrum Password right here on the Fan.
The second half of Progrum Password is next. And you can watch live on KFAN's social channels.
We get it, Vikings fans. Last weekend was painful. First, the Packers.
And the Green Bay Packers have hung 47 on the Dallas Cowboys.
Then the Lions.
The Detroit Lions have got their first postseason win in 32 years.
But it's football, and we know you love it. So the NFL playoffs will continue this weekend live on KFAN.
If you are someone who experiences migraine attacks, you know it's the everyday moments that matter.
Mom, come play with me.
The moments you don't want to miss. Nurtec ODT, rimegepant 75 milligrams orally disintegrating tablets, is the only medication proven to treat and prevent migraines all in one, giving you and your healthcare provider the power to control your migraine treatment.
Nurtec ODT is approved for the acute treatment of migraine attacks and preventative treatment of episodic migraine in adults. Don't take if allergic to Nurtec ODT. Allergic reactions can occur even days after using and include trouble breathing, rash, and swelling of the face, mouth, tongue, or throat. Most common side effects were nausea and indigestion stomach pain. For full prescribing information, call 1-833-4-NURTEC or visit Nurtec.com.
Ask your healthcare provider about Nurtec today.
We know there are a ton of options on the market when it comes to your home's windows. Let me help steer you in the right direction. Hi, this is Pat from Minn Kota Windows. We've been manufacturing windows in the upper Midwest since 1980 with Rahal quality UPVC and all climate glass. Our windows never require scraping, staining, or painting, and there are no harmful chemicals inherent to other types of vinyl on the market. So when people ask why Minn Kota Windows, it's the quality and craftsmanship behind the Midwest built, Midwest tough design. And so many options, dual or triple pane glass, several interior color options, and limitless options for the exterior. We intentionally put several locking mechanisms on all our window styles for both sealing and safety, and we offer more than standard and custom shapes and sizes. Visit us at MinnKotaWindows.com and see why Minn Kota Windows should be your window of choice. Ask for Minn Kota Windows.
Minn Kota Windows, invest in your home. Minn Kota Windows, windows for your world.
Hey, Common here for Hummingbird, a breakthrough alternative to traditional ear tube surgery. What it does is it enables physicians to place ear tubes without general anesthesia. The device has been cleared by the FDA and provides a new option for ENTs and parents to pick the best option for their kids. There's no fasting, no anesthesia, no operating room. Kids can return to normal activities right away, and parents can be there during the entire procedure. Hummingbird is an office procedure which allows many families to schedule sooner because of more flexibility in office scheduling versus the OR. If a kid needs ear tubes, you need Hummingbird. HummingbirdEarTubes.com. That's HummingbirdEarTubes.com.
For the ones who get it done, the most important part is the one you need now. And the best partner is the one who can deliver. That's why millions of maintenance and repair pros trust Grainger. Because we have professional-grade supplies for every industry, even hard-to-find products. And we have same-day pickup and next-day delivery on most orders. But most importantly, we have an unwavering commitment to help keep you up and running. Call, click Grainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
The frigid, I can say that word, Arctic air at the Cole Compound 1314 inside lane has not been a fear for us. I've got my high efficient Amana brand furnace keeping the house oasty toasty warm. Comes with top ratings for quality, warranty, and efficiencies. The best warranty in the business. A lifetime unit replacement on that high efficient furnace. If you're looking for a new furnace, or maybe you just need a tune up or a repair on your current and existing system, doesn't matter the make or model, your Amana brand preferred contractor can repair that or do the tune-up. Reach out to them today at iHeartAmana.com. That's iHeartAmana.com.
Andy is a 7-year veteran at LiUNA.
When I was laid off from another job, a few of my buddies recommended me to join LiUNA as a skilled construction laborer. I went through the apprentice program at the Laborers Training Center to learn how to work safe and productive in the trades. Everything is way better than what I had before. Better pay, better benefits, free training, steady work, and pension for retirement. If I can do it, you can too.
For career opportunities, visit buildthenorth.com.
Meat Sauce here. Football season is here, and you know what that means. Hanging out with friends and family and enjoying 7th Avenue Pizza. Pop it in the oven or even maybe try it on the grill and enjoy. Their thin crust frozen pizzas will absolutely exceed your expectations. Find 7th Avenue Pizza at Mac and Thune's.
Minnesota. The truth is, yes, COVID's still here. And yes, like the flu, it can make you seriously ill. So, yes, the latest vaccines are the way to go. And yes, you need them, even if you had COVID already. And yes, you can get them from your doctor or pharmacy. So yes, make an appointment for the whole family even. And yes, insurance should still cover it. And there are free options if you need them. So, should you ask your clinic or pharmacy about COVID and flu shots? Yes.
If you're buying an engagement ring, there's one store to go to. That's Arthur's Jewelers in Roseville. They're known for having the best engagement ring designs and selection in the Twin Cities. Arthur's has more 5-star Google reviews than any other store. They're the diamond experts, and they'll take care of you. You'll love your experience at Arthur's.
If you have unfiled taxes or are in debt to the IRS, this is important news. The IRS just rolled out a new program to help struggling taxpayers more easily resolve their tax problems. It's called the Taxpayer Relief Initiative, and it opens up powerful new options for people looking to get back on the right track with the IRS. And no one knows this program like the professionals at Optima Tax Relief, America's most trusted tax resolution company. They've resolved over $1 billion in tax debt for their clients and have the expertise and experience to help you. One easy call to Optima can start the process, helping to put an end to your worries of wage garnishment, asset seizure, and other aggressive IRS actions. Make today the beginning of your fresh start with the IRS. Call the expert at Optima Tax Relief now for your free confidential consultation.
Call 800-337-4548. That's 800-337-4548. 800-337-4548.
Optima Tax Relief.
Some restrictions apply. For complete details, please visit OptimaTaxRelief.com.
Save 24% off last year's price on any window, siding, door, or patio project at BuildersAndRemodelers.com.
From the Your Boat Club Weather Center.
This report is sponsored by Lowe's.
Fan forecast.
Chilly tonight. I'll get to a low of minus 5, 10, and sunny tomorrow, up to 20 on Sunday.
Get prepared for winter weather at Lowe's. Whether you need portable heaters, pipe wraps, generators, filters, or water heaters, visit your local Lowe's for the essentials you need. Because Lowe's knows home improvement.
Now back to the 651 Carpets Plus, home of the Next Day Install Studios, on The Fan.
Password milestone game, 141, is it?
145.
145, it's a milestone game. One text messenger said, this is driveway radio. Rosie and Joe Maurer should have moved up, not Program Password.
Wow.
I agree.
Driveway radio, you can't get out of your car.
You can't get out of your car.
You just can't get out of your car. Think about it.
To throw back to initials, parking garage radio.
Yes.
If you
see
will.
What you did there.
So there we go. So where are we at?
Is there a milestone initials game coming up soon?
I'm so glad you brought that up. today was $4.99. So next Friday is game 500. And if you function in the base 10, then you'll be very surprised that 500 means something to some of us.
Yeah.
Wow. You know, let's go.
Base 10. I don't know what that means.
100.
Can people still get into that? Or are we?
I think you can win your way in, I think.
Only way in is to win, is what we call it.
Yep. Okay.
So I'd go to KFAN.com, make the keyword contest. I'd also go to KFAN on Instagram.
I'd subscribe to our YouTube.
So would I.
That's what I would do.
It's a great channel.
It's growing.
It's growing.
Yeah.
Astronomically.
Yeah. I've been tracking it for a long time.
Numbers are obscene right now.
Didn't even know we had a boomer.
Stop. Yeah, don't tell people that.
I didn't know. I'm sorry, but now I do.
Yep, but you don't have to tell people. Just tell me.
I'm going to subscribe to it.
Oh, God.
You'd have no idea how to do it.
No, I wouldn't have any idea.
Could Common subscribe to the KFN YouTube channel in 10 minutes, over under?
That'd be a great bet.
Under.
I would say no.
No, over. What is it?
No.
10 minutes for him to find the KFN YouTube channel and subscribe to it.
No.
Mm-mm. No, because he wouldn't have,
this is a spoiler,
but he would have to have an account, figure out how to log in. No chance in 10 minutes.
I don't have a YouTube account. If I ever want to see anything on YouTube, I have to go through the ads. Because you can get it for free if you don't.
Yeah.
If you do.
Yeah.
The ads. Yeah. And if you want to ignore the ads.
You can do that and subscribe.
Do you think you are the Star Tribune equivalent of Taylor Swift and Peacock? Because I saw your picture on Twitter that there was an article about you, but I don't subscribe to Star Tribune. I'm not going to pay when I can see you at work. I'm not going to pay to read a Strib article about you and your Lions fandom.
Yeah, it was nice.
I saw the picture.
Pat Royce, he reached out and he said, "You got a picture of you and your boy in Lions regalia." And so I sent him a picture when we were at Curly, because we went to Curly together in 2018. My boy got to enjoy everything that was Curly Lambeau Field on his first visit, except for one thing. Lambeau Leap, because we shut the Packers out 30-0. So it was cool, yeah. So yeah, I wrote a nice little piece. That was nice. Misquoted me a lot, but that's okay.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
No, he didn't. I just want to say that.
Anyway.
He misquoted me. We have a heck of a game.
We're ready to play, as always, you can watch Progrum Password at KFN.com/watch. Big audience watching right now, so we appreciate everyone.
Is that right?
Watching and commenting on there for Milestone Game 145. Right now, it's a tie. It's 39-39. Common and Cove versus Lil B and Marney. Let's head back to Common and Marney. Turn your headsets down, please. The password is skunk. It's tied. The possession arrow is back on Cory and Common. So, Cory Cove, you have the option here. You want to go first or second? Five seconds.
Let's go second.
All right, Lil B and Marney for 10.
White. Lotus. It's a good show. It's a great
guess. Cory and Common for 9.
Okay, Barb. Let's go wild.
Snow.
What?
Lil B and Marney for 8.
Furry.
Cory and Common for 7.
Stink.
Skunk.
Yes. Nice try, Barb.
They were both trying
Barb tried to sabotage by going white, so I had to give a sabotage clue. Because if I go...
I thought you were going to keep going sabotaging each other.
I didn't want to... Anyway. Nice try. And she even gave me the look like, good luck with that. Good luck with what I gave you.
The sabotage ones are
fun. That definitely sounds like something I would do.
I thought we were going to sabotage each other all the way.
Well, yeah. Ooh, good one, Common.
Thank you.
Didn't know when to drop the old stink bomb on this game, but it worked.
That's 3 in a row for Common and Cory. They're on a 26-0 run. It's 46-39. They have the lead. Common and Marney, headsets down, please. No.
Wait.
That's wrong.
What are we doing?
Wait.
Hold on.
I'm down, right?
Yeah,
should we be down? Barb and I are down.
Bye.
Yes. Lil B and Cory, headsets down, please.
Yeah.
The password is dangerous. All right, Marnes. Down 7. The option is yours. You want to go first or second?
I'm going second.
All right, Common and Cory for 10.
Scary.
Horror.
Marnie and Lil B for 9.
Caution. Afraid.
Common and Cory for 8.
Harmful.
Dangerous.
Dang it. Yep. That was good.
Yeah,
that was
good.
I got it on that one.
I was on warning when you said caution, so then his clue completely threw me off.
I didn't have a guy to even know. Oof. What did I say the first time?
It's scary.
Oh, yeah. I just didn't.
That's a hard one.
It was tough to pick a direction.
We've gone past the fallness must stage.
Yeah, he's pulled out his other clipboard of words.
You can tell I made those ones for a previous matchup.
Wow. It's just a sick burn.
34-0 run for Common and Cory.
Oh, yeah.
It's 54-39. Common and Cory now have the lead. Common and Marnie, headsets down, please.
The password is gear.
All right, little B, biggest deficit for the game for you guys. You're down 15 points. What would you like to do here, first or second?
Second.
All right, Cory and Common for 10.
Shift.
Gear.
Yes. Would you have said that? It was the first thing that popped into my head.
Okay.
I thought about it, to be honest.
I just thought it...
Does this feel like a Progrum Password invitational game to you two?
Well, but nobody asked.
How about daddies?
What?
Dear daddies. Richard.
I was going to say Richard, problems. But she wouldn't have said gear. There's too many...
Yeah, I would have said...
Stop it. No.
Common and Cory, you lead 64-39. You are 16 points away from victory.
Okay.
Lil B and Cory, put your headsets down, please.
Lock in.
You okay? The password is rave.
All right, Marnie. Decision time, down 25. You guys need to go on a run here. What would you like to do, first or second?
I'll try first. I'm desperate.
Marnie and Lil B for 10.
Rager.
Party.
Common and Cove for 9.
Did I hear the word wrong?
I don't know.
Oh, boy. All right.
Can he ask to hear it again or not?
Would you like to hear it again?
Could I please?
All right. Cory and Lil B, headsets down.
We can't do that, though, right?
Yeah.
We never let Rosen get away with it back
in the
day.
I think it's a boomer thing, and he doesn't connect the two the same way, but if he didn't hear
that's probably accurate.
I don't have a problem with him hearing it again.
You can hear it again. Hold on.
Rave. R-A-V-E.
All right. Common and Cory for 9.
Rant.
Marnie and Lil B for 8.
Review.
Rave.
That was a really good clue, Common. Rant and rave.
Did you mishear it, or did you just not get their reference?
Like a rave
like
party.
Like a big party is a rave.
A rave or a rager.
I must have missed, because I thought the word was rage. So when she said rager, I thought you were going to go. I thought you were going to say, can't use that word. I thought it was our point.
Yeah.
So you did hear it wrong.
So you misheard it.
But then it got clear. When he said R-A-V-E, then you were good, right? Because you said rant. Yeah.
Yes,
so before his guess.
Okay. But now we're in trouble.
It's still all right. 64-47. Yeah. You got a 17-point lead. Common and Marnie, headsets down, please.
The password is diamond.
Lil B, the option's on you. You can make it a 7-point game here.
I'll go first.
All right, Lil B and Marnie for 10.
Continental
Diamond. Hey! Right there.
How'd you not say breakfast on that?
Because Marnie came and talked to me this morning and said, I got to go. I have a meeting at Continental Diamond.
What? It happened.
Ding. It was like Slumdog Millionaire. Okay.
Ursula Minor or Ursula Major?
I go to Arthur's. I just had to get that in. It's my client.
I'm in the market.
I love Jimmy Pesce.
I'm in the market for some jewelry. Would you meet me there?
Well, no, it's kind of out of the way for me. So, I mean, I'll give him a call and tell him you're coming.
Okay, thanks.
Send him the link.
7-point game. Common and Cory, you lead 64-57. Lil B and Cory, headsets down, please.
The password is Prince.
Marty, you can regain the lead here. You're down seven. The option's yours. What do you want to do?
I'll try first.
All right, to take the lead, Marnie and Lil B for 10.
Kiss! Prince.
Wow.
Yes! I took a risk.
That was a risk.
That was a good guess.
That was also a very high note.
Lil B and Marnie, you've hit three in a row now. You are on a 28-0 run, and you now lead 67-64. You're 13 points away from victory. Common and Marnie, headsets down, please.
The password is muffin.
Cory, down three. So the option is yours. You want to go first?
First.
And he wants to go first. Cory and Common regain lead. This for 10.
Blueberry.
Pie.
Lil B and Marnie for 9.
Pastry.
Muffin.
Yep. I was like, pie, muffin, scone.
Yeah,
there
pie
were a
makes
lot
sense
of them.
To
pie, scone?
No, when you hear blueberry, it's automatically muffin.
This is... Oh, thank you. I was going to say...
That was directed at Marty, not you, but I apologize that you took offense.
I was going to say I found my thrill on Blueberry Hill, because Hill was the other one I was going to... But that's a 1950s boomer song.
You know who makes really good blueberry pies? Hmm. Meat sauce.
You know what...
just ask him.
You know what happened here? It all turned around when I had that senior moment.
Your boomer moment.
And I had that boomer moment. And I couldn't remember the word or heard it wrong or whatever it was.
It's not over
that's
yet.
That's when it all went.
We can still do this.
Yet.
We're going to have,
that's where it went wrong.
We're going to have the control twice.
Clue. You gave a that was better a clue than I did.
Not everyone's wrong. Like Rosen where you feel like you're 45.
Wow.
When you get older.
See, with this score, they could never have the ball again.
Yeah,
we just get the next two and it's over.
All right, very good.
That's right. Lil B and Marnie, you lead 76-64. So any correct answer for Lil B and Marnie, you win. Common and Cory, you are 16 points away, but you'll have the options.
Barnes, we need this.
Lil B and Cory, headsets down, please.
The password is cheat.
Common, you're down 12 points. You have the option here.
Are you laughing at chuckles?
I'm going to go first.
I saw this all right. Coming. Common and Cory for 10.
Rosen.
Fraud.
Marty and Lil B for 9 and the win.
Test.
Cheat.
Yes.
Yes!
They've done it.
Victory.
The winning streak for Cory Cove is over. It ends at 8. And Marty, you are now the winningest player in Progrum Password history.
Think about it.
The
problem is there's too many things with Rosen.
Yeah, yeah.
Fraud. I thought it was vacation.
A vacation.
So when you said test, okay,
elderly.
Boomer. That's my fault.
Guys,
Boomer
that was a fun game, though. That was really good.
That was really fun.
Good.
The Boomer blew it. Sorry about that.
I'd rather do that every week. That's fun.
As soon as he said cheat, I knew where you were going to go.
Yes, so did I.
And you started laughing, and I'm like, yep.
We were right on the borderline.
You were
on the borderline.
See, I like this song better than that other one, too.
This is a good song.
Yeah.
I'm a big Madonna. Yeah.
Go look at her face.
I like all those 80s. Boy George, Cindy Lauper. Like
80s pop music is the best era of pop music, and it's not even close.
Agree and disagree.
I tend to agree.
I just don't like 80s music. Never did.
80s into 90s.
Congratulations, ladies. You deserved it.
Good game, guys. That was fun.
Yes, very much. Cory Cove, Maestro of the Mornings.
And none of us Rosened.
Yeah.
None of us did.
We played it straight up.
Yes.
And that's all that matters.
Thanks for agreeing to come in again.
That was fun.
Good luck on your, it's a milestone game. And initials Friday, game 500.
You know this. I don't do it for the praise or the applause or the thanks. I do it for people to go to initialsgame.com and just buy the home version and give me their money.
By the way, I'm selling books still.
Is that right?
I'm sending out 3 today.
Three?
And people are still buying it, believe it or not, and there are not many left. We're at about
Joe
Mauer's
trying to sell books, too.
Yes. Matter of fact, he's going to talk about that next.
Yes.
Again, Cory and Marnes, thanks for coming in.
Thank you.
As always, Lil B, thanks.
Thanks, guys.
You bet. We'll take a break. We'll come back. Lil B's appearance brought to you by Casey's. Well, Joe Mauer, Joe Schmit, Mark Rosen next year on The Fan.
And you can watch it at KFAN.com/watch.
Mark Rosen joins the Common Man.
Oh, boy.
Next on The Fan.
KFAN. Total traffic.
From the Quick Trip Traffic Center, here's a look at the roads. 94 westbound at Mons Boulevard, a disabled vehicle on the left shoulder. From 494, 694 to 35E, 7 minutes. 694 westbound at East River Road, disabled vehicle, right shoulder. Crosstown Highway eastbound at 28th Avenue, disabled vehicle, right shoulder. 35W southbound at Washington Avenue, disabled vehicle, left shoulder. From Forest Lake Split to downtown Minneapolis, 22 minutes. That's traffic on The Fan. Traffic is sponsored by Luther Brookdale Mitsubishi.
Luther Brookdale Mitsubishi. 0% interest up to 60 months on new Outlanders and Eclipse Cross. Ask about our lease specials. World-class facility and customer service at Luther Brookdale Mitsubishi. See dealer for details. Brookdale-Mitsubishi.com. Your 10-diamond Mitsubishi dealer.
Rosie here. Your BoatClub.com's annual live auction runs January 11th through the 28th with the best used pontoons, runabouts, and fishing boats for sale at prices that can't be beat. Bid online January 11th through the 28th at yourboatclub.com.
Hey, the Common Man here for Casey's, and Casey's is here with a special treat for Casey's Rewards members for a limited time only. You drop by Casey's on any Monday, and you'll get a free cup of coffee. It's a token of their appreciation, a perk. Get it? Percolator? Yes, right. It's a special perk for being a Casey's Rewards member. And when you buy one large single-topping pizza, you get another half off when you use the promo code BOGO. It's available on their original or thin crust. Order online or in the app if you're not a Casey's Reward member. Just download the Casey's app and you're well on your way, only at Casey's.
The Upper Midwest's biggest boat sale, the Discover Boating Minneapolis Boat Show, in partnership with Progressive Insurance, is going on now through Sunday at the Minneapolis Convention Center. With new models, top brands, and the latest gear, there's no better place to see and buy boats. MinneapolisBoatShow.com.
At Progressive, we love sports and saving you money, so we bundled them together.
Top of the seventh looks like a pitching change as they've set up for a corner kick. The two black belts have entered the mat, and the slider is low and away. He heads the ball to midfield. This is quite a kumite. Here comes the roundhouse. Has it got enough gas to get out of here? Unbelievable! They've bundled their home and auto insurance with Progressive. Kick savings, pitch karate.
Progressive Casualty Insurance Company affiliates and other insurers. Not available in all states or situations.
This is the Golden Gopher Daily Update. I'm Mike Graham. We'll talk Minnesota hockey when we come back.
When we say that Cub milk is the freshest in town, we mean it. Less than 48 hours from farm to store fresh. We guarantee 7 days or more of freshness. It all starts with local dairy farmers who take great care in making sure all the cows are happy and healthy. We support local farm families 365 days a year. And that makes our milk even more delicious. So you always get the freshest milk and the biggest smiles.
The 10th-ranked Golden Gopher men's hockey team returns to Big Ten action by hosting Ohio State tonight and tomorrow. Head coach Bob Motzko says they remember splitting a series with the Buckeyes in Columbus in December.
The big thing for us is special teams with Ohio State. You know, we got to get to their goalie. We got to put pressure. I know we got to their goalie the first night, and then they put a young kid in that hadn't played much, and he shut the door on it. And we won that first night. The next night was 1-1, and they played that young kid, and it was an even game. And they, you know, they got the shootout. Is that another one of our shootout losses? Goaltending, I think, has been one of their issues, and it's kind of been feast and famine. You know, real strong, or you can get to them, They have a transfer goalie that came in there that with their young freshmen. So we have to win the special team battle, and we have to find a way to get it their goaltender.
That's Gopher coach Bob Motzko. Both tonight and tomorrow's games begin at 7 o'clock at 3M Arena at Mariucci. Meanwhile, the 5th-ranked Gopher women's hockey team will play at Bemidji State tonight and tomorrow afternoon. For more info on Gopher hockey, go to gophersports.com. That's the Golden Gopher Daily Update. I'm Mike Graham.
Wild Panthers, today at 5 on the radio home of the Wild, FM 100.3, KFXN, Minneapolis-St. Paul, The Fan.
the best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest. You can beat the world, you can beat the war. You can talk the guy, go banging on his door. You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock. You can move a mountain, you can break rocks. You can be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you can find yourself.
Standing in the hall of fame.
13-14 pass on the Common Man, Dan Cole, along with Tenna. Be excited and delighted to be joined by Joe Schmit of Channel 5.
Good it's to great to be here, Common.
Yeah, it's good to see you again.
Yeah.
Joel Mauer, former Twin and soon to be Major League Baseball Hall of Famer, we believe. And then, of course, the legendary Mark Rosen. Okay. I'm not as delighted and excited to see you as I am them because I see you.
I can't imagine why.
I see you all the time.
Yeah, this is great. We're really excited. I appreciate these guys reaching out to me, and we have a couple segments with Joe. He's a very busy man today. Yeah. When I say Joe, I got to be careful now because we got two Joes in here.
I also want to right away clear something up, Joe, between you and I. I'm unlike most of the media people you probably deal with are very unathletic, right, and don't, you know, barely can, you know, they got two left feet. I'm a three-sport star like you were. First through sixth grade, I played Pee Wee and Pony League baseball over in Coon Rapids over at Kennedy Park. The only reason why I quit after seventh grade because I couldn't hit a curveball.
Yeah.
You wouldn't know about that, but I couldn't hit a curveball. I was also Coon Rapids Athletic Association, played fourth, fifth, and sixth grade football, much like you did. And you were rated as the top high school quarterback in your class coming out. I was a fierce pass-rushing, Rock of Gibraltar run-stopping defensive lineman and a precise route-running, sure-handed pass-catching tight end. Yeah. And unlike basketball, I'm vertically challenged, as you can see. I was a track and field star. I won the blue ribbon at Adams School Elementary School, sixth grade track and field day in the sack race.
That's underrated.
It is. So I'm a three-sport star. So just, you know, you're on the same level with somebody who's achieved the same kind of thing.
Absolutely. And believe it or not, I was a defensive end back in the fifth and sixth grade as well. So, yeah, we do have a lot
of
common
there. So you
played
both sides of the ball.
Yeah, I did. And that was the last year of my sixth grade playing defense.
That was the end of it.
On the football side. Yeah, they thought I should just focus on being a quarterback, so that's what I did.
Well, good to have you in, and Joe, you're here as well because, I mean, we know it's Hall of Fame next week and that for the Major League Baseball, but you and Joe put a book together, a kids' book together.
Yeah, you know, and I got to tell you, I kind of had to talk Joe into it. You know, I wrote a book 9 years ago called Silent Impact, and in that book I wrote about how Joe walked a blind student to lunch every day at Creighton-Durham Hall, and then I interviewed everybody around the school and how much impact it had on so many people. It's a really nice story. Well, anyway, my publisher called me and said, you got to write a kid's book. I said, a kid's book? You got to be crazy. Well, anyway, the more and more I thought about it, I thought this might work. Called Joe up. We had breakfast, Maddie, his wife, and me, and we came up with the idea. Let's give this all the money to charity. Let's see if people will donate money so we can donate books to schools around the country, around the state. And right now we have we're going to be donating books to 500 elementary schools in Minnesota. We've had enough sponsorship and support already,
and it kind of covers two main areas, is it not? Because you know, as both you guys as parents, I know there are a lot of challenges kids have, and then the world we live in with social media, peer pressure, et cetera, but it goes beyond that into with kids with disabilities, mental health issues, whatever it might be. So maybe both of you could speak to that. And Joe Mauer, I'm looking at Joe Mauer, and the importance of that aspect of this book.
Yeah, you know, like Joe said, at first, you know, I've been pitched a lot of book ideas over the years. But, you know, I was a little reluctant at first, but then kind of hearing from Joe and kind of, you know, obviously the 100% of the proceeds going to two of our charities locally here. Was a big deal of it, but I also wanted to have Mike Halley on board, you know, my classmate back in at Creighton-Durham Hall, that we had lunch every day there and our senior year, but I just wanted to make sure that he was good with it and we were doing it for the right reasons. Mm-hmm. And you know, it's a great opportunity to send a positive message out there and also put a couple of the lessons that I've learned over the years from my parents, you know, into a book and share that with my kids and hopefully other kids all over the country.
It's a hardcover book. 100% of the profits from the book will benefit the nonprofits Thumbs Up and Highland Friendship Club. It's called The Right Thing to Do, the Joe Mauer Story.
And can I tell you just how that started? So when I got into speaking, and I speak all over the place, and I did this story with Joe, and I said, Joe, why did you walk Mike Halley to the lunchroom every day, you know, 22 years ago? And Joe's answer was, it was the right thing to do.
Yeah.
Thus, we had the name of the book, it was pretty obvious that that was going to be the name of the book. And then when I looked at it, all these values that Joe got from his mom and dad. And I just want to say something real quickly about the two charities, because Mark kind of mentioned it. Mm-hmm. Thumbs Up for Mental Health mm-hmm. is a charity that started because of this story. A young woman by the name of Katie Shatusky in Elk River read the story and thought, if Joe can do something, I can do something. She started a charity that helps kids, junior high school kids battling with mental health. Mm-hmm. Sometimes the outcast, the kids who would sit alone at the lunchroom. She started a program called No One Sits Solo. They have a curriculum with it. They're in three school districts already. They want to take the program statewide. Highland Friendship Club, Joe's been with it since its very beginning. I'll let you talk about that real quick.
Yeah, I mean, so my best friend, Tony Leisman, his mom started the program back in Highland Park. I don't want to say how many years ago, but, you know, it's great. It's for young adults and kids with disabilities, just kind of a community to get together and do different activities and meet other families and really help places them in the community too to be productive contributors to the community. So Highland Friendship Club and Thumbs Up, I would encourage everybody to do a little bit more digging on both of those charities, because they're close to our hearts, but they're great organizations and they do a lot of good in our community.
You talk about parents' involvement and Joe. I'm talking to Joe Maurer right now. And we had a chance with the introduction as well to say something about your dad, who unfortunately passed a year ago, wasn't it?
Yeah.
1 year
January,
ago.
January 17th.
Yeah, so and what he meant to the Maurer kids and what it was like. And it's, I'm sure it was reassuring and reaffirming to be able to kind of tell that, get that off your chest and kind of recognize the importance of your dad.
Yeah, and this is kind of a unique way for me to kind of pay tribute to him, you know, things that I've learned over the years. And you know, my mom as well. I mean, they're... huge influences in my life, and you know, this was a way to put it out there, and my hope for this book is to spark conversations, you know, between parents and their kids and teachers and the kids. And you know, I know when I read to my kids, we talk about the story and kind of what happened, and my hope for this book is to start those conversations of why it is important to be kind and treat people of all walks of life the same, and usually that's returned to you in the end too.
This is interesting here as I look at the book, because I'm going to make this about me. Just, I have a book as well, but here's what's interesting. Written by Joe Schmit. Mine was written by me. The foreword in Joe's book is by Joe. Mark Rosen wrote the foreword in my book. So Joe Maurer and Mark Rosen both have the same thing in common.
How about that?
Forewords in books. Think about that. They both wrote forewords. I kind of like that.
Yeah. And I know you guys are going to have opportunities, and I'm sure the public listening right now, Joe Schmit, in terms of where they can either get a hold of this book.
Yep.
I know Twins Fest is coming up.
We are at
talk
Twins
to
Fest.
That. Okay.
Yep. We're going to be at Twins Fest all day on Saturday the 27th.
It's coming up, yeah.
And right now you can buy it online, joemaurerbook.com, and you can also donate, like I said, books to our Give Books to School program. And it's interesting how quickly they turn around. But I do want to say something. The artist on this book, the illustrator, was Kevin Cannon. Tell me, guys, isn't this a beautiful book?
It's amazing.
I mean, it's just so, it's like the prettiest book I think I've ever seen.
Yeah, he did a phenomenal job. And it's going to be one of those things. I mean, Brandon's got young kids. I mean, if you have young kids and bring this home to them, they're gonna want you to read it to them about 30 times over and over, which is what the purpose is. It is. He did a marvelous job with all of it.
He did. I got my hands on it for the first time today, and I think it turned out great. You know, we've been in contact through email and, you know, kind of what it might look like, but I think he knocked it out of the park, to use a baseball term there.
Until you can get your hands on it.
Amy Quayle Wise Inc., right?
Yeah, because
Kevin Cannon did the illustrations in my book, too.
Oh, did he really?
He's terrific. He's brilliant.
Yeah.
He's a great artist.
Yeah, he is.
Amy Quayle and Wise Inc. is a great, great company. They're local here in the Twin Cities.
She's the one who talked me into doing the book. I was telling Mark before we came on, I was like, she had called me. I'd written two books, and she said, Joe, you have to write another book. And I was like, I don't want to write another book. That's too painful. And then she said, have you thought about a children's book on Joe Maurer? And that's how it started.
Yep. Yeah, Amy does a terrific job of the local. Yep. They do mostly locally based authors or people that even have, like when they approach people and say, we think it's a good idea, you write a book. You go, me? Who? What? And then you do it, and it works out pretty well.
We obviously have something to talk about that's coming up next week, which I believe
What's
is
that?
On your mind. But before we do, Joe Maurer, I want to talk about, since you are, last time I saw you, I think was one of the Twins events, but twin daughters, now you have a son.
Yeah.
So what is life like for Joe Maurer these days? hectic, involved with your kids as much as possible. It's
definitely
world.
Busy for sure. It's been busy. It's been a lot of fun though. The girls are 10 now.
Oh my.
Fourth grade. It's amazing how quickly that goes. And Chip just turned 5. So we're full speed ahead. But I was just telling Joe earlier today, we just got the signups for softball and baseball this past week. So looking forward to coaching both.
I was going to ask you, you do want to coach your own kids.
Yeah. So I did last year and it was a blast. You know, it's entertaining, a lot of stories from coaching. We have a good time and it's fun to watch the progress at this age, you know, 10 years old, the girls like first day compared to the last game. It's amazing how much they improve and how fun it is to see them get excited about
one thing we've talked about on this show quite a bit. I'm sorry, Colin, interject as well, but and this is about this as well, but not having and we Colin talked about it. He was a star in 3 different sports. Mm-hmm. From your perspective, a guy looks like he's going to be going into the Baseball Hall of Fame next week, not to concentrate on one sport. When you grew up with your brothers and your parents and the idea that the specialization that goes on in sports today, what is your advice to parents when it comes to all of that?
Yeah, and as a parent, you know, with kids at that age right now, I'm just trying to throw a lot of different things at them, you know, and see what sticks. But, it's hard. I mean, even when I was in high school, you know, I won't say how many years ago. My sports overlapped. You know, I missed a couple weeks of basketball due to football, or I missed a couple weeks of baseball because of basketball. So it definitely is challenging, even more so today. But, you know, I just say as long as you enjoy them, you know, go out there and try to play them, you know, and I enjoyed them.
Could this coaching lead to a managerial career in the major league level?
I don't know. It might be a little different, the 10-year-old circuit versus the big league.
Well, you got to start somewhere. We'll take a break. We'll come back. We got one more segment to go with Joe Maurer, Joe Schmit, Rosie, along with Common. We'll take a short break, come back with one more segment. Talk a little bit about the possibilities of Joe entering the Hall of Fame. They look pretty good right now. We'll talk about that next here on The Fan.
Hey, The Fan and the Big Ten Conference want to give you a shot to put a grand in your hand with our national cash.
He has a father-son-like relationship with Joe Maurer. It's Mark Rosen with the Common Man, Dan Cole, on The Fan.
KFAN, Total Traffic.
From the Quick Trip Traffic Center, here's a look at the roads. 94 westbound at Mounds Boulevard, disabled vehicle left shoulder. 694 westbound at East River Road, disabled vehicle right shoulder. 394 eastbound at Slope, Penn Avenue to Dunwoody. Crosstown Highway eastbound at 28th Avenue, disabled vehicle right shoulder. 35W southbound off-ramp to 3rd Street, a crash on the exit ramp. From Forest Lake Split to downtown Minneapolis, 22 minutes. That's traffic on The Fan. Traffic is sponsored by Luther Brookdale Mazda.
Where do you find 0% for 36 to 60 months on all Mazda SUVs? No payments until April. Bonus cash and trade-in bonus. Free oil changes. Gas and car wash discounts. Only at Luther Mazda. LutherMazda.com. See dealer for details. The only thing we overlook is 694.
Hey, Tenna B here for Underdog Fantasy. We got some playoff action this weekend, and you should do what I do and play the Pick'em game this weekend at Underdog Fantasy, the best place to play fantasy football. When I'm playing the Pick'em game, I'm looking at C.J. Stroud at Baltimore. Right now, 243.5 passing yards. I think he'll go higher than that. He's been red hot. Could also be trailing in that game, having to play catch-up. So I'll take Stroud higher than 243.5 passing yards. The way you play the Pick'em game, you pick between 2 and 5 players, select higher or lower on one of their stats, and then if your picks hit, you could win up to 100 times your money. It's super easy to play at Underdog, even easier to get started. Just go to their mobile app or go to underdogfantasy.com. Sign up with the promo code KFAN, and Underdog will double your first deposit up to $100. Plus, they'll give you a special pick of higher than 0.5 total yards to use on your first Pick'em entry. That's Underdog Fantasy. Use my promo code KFAN to get your first deposit of $10 or more, up to $100 doubled, plus your special pick. Must be 18 plus and present in a state where Underdog Fantasy operates. Terms apply. If you're concerned with the play, call 1-800-GAMBLER or visit www.ncpgambling.org.
If you're buying an engagement ring, there's one store to go to. That's Arthur's Jewelers in Roseville. They're known for having the best engagement ring designs and selection in the Twin Cities. Arthur's has more 5-star Google reviews than any other store. They're the diamond experts, and they'll take care of you. You'll love your experience at Arthur's.
Your nose is for breathing. Your mouth is for eating. And if you're breathing through your mouth, it's not because your body wants to. It's because it has to, because your nose isn't working properly. And although you've lived like this, it's no way to live, and it's having a significant impact on your life. I know you know this, and I know that taking action isn't always convenient. But at Advent, we've done all we can to make changing your life for the better as easy as possible. I'm Dr. Madan Kandula. With tens of thousands of our patients, a thorough breathing triangle evaluation, along with a simple 20-minute in-office procedure called balloon sinuplasty, has opened their nasal passages, allowing them to breathe freely through their nose for good. And there's a good chance this procedure can do the same for you. We'll help you breathe through your nose again, and it will change your life.
Go to AdventNose.com to schedule your appointment, because Advent knows when you breathe well, you live better.
Hey, Common here with four Casey's, and Casey's has a great special treat for Casey's Rewards members. For a limited time only, you drop by Casey's on any Monday, you get a free cup of coffee. It's a special perk for being a Casey's Rewards member. And then when you buy one large single-topping pizza, you get another large single-topping pizza half off when you use the promo code BOGO. You can get it on thin or original crust, whichever you prefer. Order online or in the app. If you're not a Casey's Rewards member, just download the Casey's app and you're well on your way. That's only at Casey's.
This is a special alert to all Americans who own a vehicle with less than 200,000 miles with an auto warranty about to expire or with no warranty coverage at all. Due to a decline in the economy, CarShield is announcing a low-cost, month-to-month vehicle protection plan that is now available to the public to save any driver out-of-pocket expenses on future auto repairs. Call now to find out how you can pay almost nothing for covered auto repairs. Yes, you heard that correctly. Pay almost nothing for covered auto repairs. An open phone line has been established for all drivers to call for a free quick quote. Call 800-903-9880 now. Drivers who are covered will not have to pay for covered repairs again. This protection plan is at an all-time low. Additionally, drivers who activate this vehicle protection today will also receive free roadside assistance, free towing, and car rental options at no additional cost. Call us for your free quick quote today. 800-903-9880. That's 800-903-9880. What do you have to lose? Call 800-903-9880. Again, 800-903-9880.
Mauer GMC in Inver Grove Heights is your new Twin Cities GMC dealer. And right now, Mauer GMC is offering up to $5,000 off Sierra 1500s until January 31st. Find a great selection of professional-grade Sierras with all the extras. The new Mauer GMC has all you need: selection, service, and financing. Browse their website or visit their newly remodeled showroom. Enjoy up to $5,000 off on Sierra 1500s now through January 31st at the new Mauer GMC. Visit MauerGMC.com. GMC, we are professional grade.
You're listening live to the Common Man, Dan Cole, on iHeartRadio and FM 100.3 KFAN, The Fan.
Couple 13, 14 past here on the Common Man program on a FedEx Friday. I'm Comedy's 10 to be Joe Schmit, Mark Rosen, and Joe Mauer here.
Yes, go ahead. I'm sorry. I got to turn the mic on. Joe, I'll do those ads for your brother for half of what Common charges.
I said the timing could not have been better. Yeah, it was planned or something. Mauer Chev.
Don't be over there underselling me.
Well, we're here for all the right reasons, because the right thing to do is out. Joe Schmit and Joe Mauer, a great children's book that I know is going to be a big hit with people, and all the proceeds go into a couple different charities, which they describe, but we have to turn the page because you don't have too much more time here, Joe Mauer. And
well, I crunched a bunch of numbers, too. You're waiting for the Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
15 seasons, 2003 to 2018, 10 of them as a catcher. One AL MVP, 2009. Six All-Star games, three AL batting titles, a 306 career batting average. There are only 343 members in baseball's Hall of Fame. 270 are players, including 40 execs and pioneers, 23 managers, 10 umpires. 58 first ballot only, and only one first ballot unanimous, which was Mariano Rivera. As they've been, the baseball writers, as they're voting, they kind of leak these out. It sort of seems, from everything I can tell, looks like you're going to be a first
tracking pretty ballot well
Hall of Fame.
Well, that's the thing. You never know.
Right.
You know, and that's the thing. It's, I was asked this question earlier this morning, and I'm kind of in the same spot I was months ago. It's a hurry up and wait type of state, but you know, I'm curious to see how it all shake out, obviously, and excited, for that announcement. And, But yeah, Tuesday, you know, they call you or they don't, and I'll be ready for it. And either way, but yeah, it's an exciting time, and really, I don't know how it'll all shake out. Yeah.
It's a 5 o'clock, I believe, on Tuesday. I think Major League Baseball actually, the network carries it live. So you would be in great company, and just in your St. Paul buddies with Paul Molitor and Dave Winfield. Jack Morris got in as a legend, but they say something's in the water. But how much would that mean to you to be just with that group when you hear the word Cooperstown, then you realize some of the names that preceded you?
Yeah, it's, I mean, like you said, it's the exclusive group. There's not many in it. And, you know, be on the ballot's an accomplishment in itself. You know, you have to play 15 years or, and there's criteria for that. But, yeah, I mean, I'm, you know, people are telling me kind of where I'm at tracking and all this, and excited about it. And yeah, I mean, that would be an unbelievable call to receive. And you know, if it happens this year, that would be wonderful. I really,
how do you approach your Tuesday then? Are you gonna just hang out with the kids and do your normal stuff?
That's the thing, you know, everybody's asking, what are you gonna do, who's gonna be there? And you know, I think for me, I'm just kind of gonna lay low with the family and see what happens. Hopefully we get the call, but you know, we'll just wait and see.
And yeah, I'm sure you've had a lot of well-wishers, people wishing you good luck. Have any of the other three St. Paulites reached out to you, Morris, Winnie, or Molitor, and said, hey, hope to see you inside the hall?
They have in the past. Okay. But, you know, that's the thing. It's, I don't know, it's interesting. They understand more than anybody the position that I'm in right now, you know, with that call or that phone could ring and it could not. So, you know, there's really not much you can do, and that's kind of what they relayed to me. And so I'm not really doing a whole lot until it happens.
By the way, you guys should hear what the schedule is if he gets the vote.
I don't know, really,
you got to disclose that.
They have mentioned that if you do receive the call, it's kind of a whirlwind, especially the rest of that week, but the whole summer.
So, right, I can imagine.
I wouldn't mind or complain if that happens.
you want the whirlwind? Yeah, okay.
That would be okay.
You know, I had a chance to share a few minutes with you during the tree lighting ceremony over Viking Lakes, and we were having something in the warming house there, and I was just kind of asking about baseball in general, and we just had a quick conversation. And it's interesting, I tell people when I ask you, I said, so what do you think about the rule changes in baseball? You even said, well, I don't watch that much baseball. And I find that kind of interesting because you think most people that were involved is their life's work was playing baseball, football, hockey, whatever. They would just be, you know, glued to it. And you said, you catch games, but it's not like you're razor focused on it.
Yeah, well, I love the game, obviously. Right. And I think the biggest thing about the game that I loved was competing. You know, I love to compete. I played multiple sports, but for me, you know, once I retired, I definitely, a baseball game was on, I would watch it, but my focus shifted to family and kind of what my kids were doing, and that was the top priority, and it still is. But we make it out to Twins games, but you know, haven't been as involved as I was, obviously, when I was playing and up to date. But I get updates from my buddies, you know, Justin Morneau, who's in the thick of things,
right,
watching it every day, and you know, we have a text thread with some of the old Twins players. There's probably a dozen of us on there that we kind of talk, you know, World Series, you know, we're texting, can you believe this guy did that? Or, you know, we're talking baseball, but it is fun, you know, and following the postseason, and you know, it was fun to watch the Twins run this past fall, and hopefully we can get some more postseason baseball here, you know, in the Twin Cities
as
in the
future. As a longtime former catcher, what are your thoughts about, you know, having robotic umpires? After dealing with umpires for and managing to keep your cool for the most part, I think, over all those years. But there's a lot of talk about that, about making it, you know, an automated strike zone.
Yeah, you know, and I think that's the thing. Major League Baseball has implemented a lot of rules just in the past few years. And I think their heart's in the right place. They're trying to make the game better for everybody. Some have worked and some have not. For myself, being a catcher and the relationship with an umpire, working with him and trying to get calls for your guy and, you know, trying to get calls for yourself when you come up to hit, I love that part of the game. And to see that kind of just go to a machine or something else, I mean, in my opinion, I don't want to see it go that way. But you do want, you know, the calls to be right. And you know, the umpires do too. So at the end of the day, we're all trying to make the game better and better for the players, the coaches, and the fans as well. So
you told me at first that you weren't real thrilled about the pitch clock idea, right? But then as you've watched it, you've kind of thought maybe it is for the better. Is that correct?
Yeah, and you know, our conversation, some of the rules that they implemented this past year, the pitch clock and, you know, sliding into home plate, those were just kind of the unwritten rules that you would learn as a young player. And, you know, as a young player, when I was coming up, you had to be ready to hit. You had to be ready to get your pitcher ready to pitch. And I'm sad to see that there had to be rules implemented to get back to that. But, you know, I think they're doing their, you know, what's intended to do is to speed the game up and keep the ball in play and keep the players moving. So I didn't like it at first, but I liked the result of it this past season, was seeing the game times come down and the ball in play more often.
You mentioned if you get the call on Tuesday at 5 o'clock, there'll be a whirlwind schedule for you. Have you ever been to Cooperstown?
I have. So my rookie year, I was out there 2004. I played in the Hall of Fame game, which was a day off. I can't remember. Maybe it was in early July. So I got to play on Double Day Field as a rookie there, which was cool. But then I got to go out there for Tony Oliva and Jim Cott's induction. Is that 2 years ago now?
I think it was 2 years ago.
Yeah. But yeah, it's to go out there and kind of experience that and support Tony and Jim. That was unbelievable. And it was also a little uncomfortable because people were saying, oh, well, let's go do this again, you know, for you in a couple of years. So, but I was there, you know, to support Tony and, you know, to go back for an induction or that would be awesome.
Well, best of luck to you. I know you guys got to run, but, and best of luck to you on the book too, the Right Thing to Do, the Joe Mauer story written by Joe Schmit, forward by Joe Mauer. 100% of the profits go to Thumbs Up and Highland Friendship Club, which are charities that are near and dear to your heart. Kind of looks like you're getting in, so best of luck to you on the book and the Hall of Fame. And Joe, thanks a lot for reaching out to us to have Joe on today. Yeah. Great.
Well, I'll tell you what, I just want to say Mark and I competed for years, but I always had a lot of respect for him. And when Joe and I talked who to talk to, his was one of the first names that came up.
Well, I appreciate it.
You know, that goes really.
Listen, I remember seeing this guy, one of my first memories is at the old St. Paul Saints Stadium. Midway Stadium. I think you were playing high school baseball, and you were coming out in the concourse area. Maybe the game had just completed with a couple of your teammates walking through there with a bat over your shoulder. Yeah. And I think, like, that seemed like yesterday.
I know.
Doesn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, time sure does fly. And it's amazing. But, obviously, thank you for having us today.
Yeah, thanks, guys. Good luck with everything.
Great amount of respect for everybody in this room. So.
Lastly, for you, one quick text message from Papa Taco. He says, tell Joe he's got a standing invitation to join the 35-plus Lakeville Lobos team.
So if you feel
like you want to get back out of the field, the Lakeville Lobos would have you.
All right.
So just keep that in mind.
That's good to know.
Tom will get you on the golf course.
Yeah, we'll play golf sometime, too. Thanks again. We'll take a break. Come back. One more segment to go here on The Fan.